But now let's get just a little more practiced with debugging. Let's say that I make a mistake. There's a bug in my code. So I've introduced a bug in the code, and now let's rerun it. Uh-oh, this is tricky output. If you look here, there are still 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 answers, but they're not the right ones, like this LM, ECS, SBA. It's mistakenly included twice, and it should only appear once as a possibility. SBA alone, once, twice, 3 times, 4 times. So here we're getting the wrong answer. How do we go about debugging it? One of the first steps is to make a test case that shows the problem. And we've made one, but it's kind of big. Let's see if we can see the problem with a smaller test input. How about just 2 people? There should be 4 possibilities, all different. Let's see what we get. We do get 4 possibilities, but they're not all different. I should get Lucretia and Elizabeth, just Lucretia, just Elizabeth, and no one. But instead, I'm getting the same thing twice in a row. So even this smaller test case still shows the bug. Okay, maybe I can make a super small test case and still see the bug. How about just Lucretia? Oh, even this shows the bug because the 2 answers should be she shows up and she doesn't, but instead both of the worlds I'm seeing are she shows up. So now we have a very small test case where the output we observe disagrees with our intuition or the problem specification. Now we're going to go try to localize the bug, like figure out which line the bug is on. And one way to do that is to add print statements. So here I've just added a print statement for big list and a print statement for selected so far so that we can see what's going on with every recursive call. Here's a quick quiz for you. How many times do you think we'll see big list printed out? I think it's going to be 3. Once for the main call down here, and then we'll call ourselves recursively 2 more times, and then each one of those will stop. And in fact, that's what we get. 1, 2, 3 printings of big list. Now let's trace through and see if this matches with our intuition. The big list comes in holding Lucretia, and we haven't selected anything so far. That's good. And now we make 2 recursive calls. The big list, we've pulled off Lucretia. Okay, that part's correct. And selected so far, we've selected Lucretia. Okay, that's possible. Remember, there are 2 worlds, one where she accepts our invitation and we select her, one where she doesn't. But then as I look down here, for this next recursive call, the big list is empty again. That's correct, because with every recursive call, we have to pull something off it. But selected so far is Lucretia again. So here, this is in both worlds, she's invited our invitation. Now that's really nice, because we're super popular, but it's not the specification of the problem. So it tells me that for one of these recursive calls, selected so far is being set incorrectly. So now I know the problem is either here or here. I've narrowed it down to 2 expressions in 2 lines because I know that on the recursive call, selected so far is being set incorrectly, and it's set based on the value of this second actual argument. All right, well, let's say I look at this and I think, well, I should only be adding this current element 1 out of 2 times. In one world, she accepts my invitation, and in one, she doesn't. So let's say over here, I'm not supposed to include current element. So let's see if removing it fixes the bug. Well, on this very simple test case, it now works. Our answer is sometimes Lucretia shows up and sometimes she doesn't. So we might be tempted to declare moral victory, be carried through the streets in triumphal march, but let's go back to our other test cases and make sure that this bug really fixed the more complicated ones.